I was telling him I'd go visit him tomorrow, but it seems like he was troubled. Cold. What do I do? Who do I talk to solve this case? This guy? Hey, I was doing some reading here. Then it suddenly went dark and I dozed off. I didn't know he was dead until I woke up. That seems a little bullshit. He was murdered, really. He wasn't a bad guy, though. To stab with a knife like that. I'm pretty sure A is definitely fucking one. Because it just seems pretty obvious that A did it. I mean, it seems obvious, but I could be wrong. I went to play outside. I was just here for some tools. I don't know anything about him. Calm down. I can't believe he was dragged here. Those footprints are big, so it must... See, that's a thing, though. No. D has to be it, because that's bullshit. No one said anything about being dragged. The guy, we said he walked in here. I don't know about A, though. A seems definitely... But D is definitely fucking wrong. Must have been a man. That's bullshit. E. Yeah, I was here, but I left right away. He wasn't even here then. I don't know. Got it? Write the two culprits on this paper. That should do it. Oh! No, I'm not ready to do this! I'm gonna say D. Definitely D. And D again. Nope, think it over one more time. Plus, the culprits are still here. I might not have much time. Hey, which one's the culprit? He was dead when I got here. Ooh, I'm scared. I'm more concerned with that being... That person's saying, like, I want to go play outside. It's like... The person's saying, calm down, definitely fucking murdered it. Hey, I was doing some reading. Then it suddenly went dark and I dozed off. I didn't know he was dead until I woke up. B. He was murdered? Really? He wasn't a bad guy, though. To stab him with a knife like that? Wasn't he, like, slit? But I don't think anyone else knew he died from a knife, actually. I think B and D are the ones who did it. Because no one else said anything that had to do with some form of the murder when the lights went out. Yeah, it has to be B and D then. Right, I explained it, and he seems to understand. It should be fine now. Killing a person, what an awful thing to do. Let's go. Go where? Where to? Where can we possibly go to? Also, what is that? Is that like a zero? I assume it's a zero. No, that's a zero. What the fuck is... What is that? Is it like a nine? Is that like a broken-ass nine? I don't know. But, okay, so I don't know where we go after this now. Do we just leave? Well, I didn't get the thingy yet, so let's go, what was that thingy? The shard. I haven't gotten the shard yet, so let's go back to the starting area. I feel like we might have missed something. There's no shiny bits in here. Maybe there was a shiny bit back here. Whoops. No, okay, there's nothing. Pretty sure you get stuck behind the shiny bits. I forgot, I didn't grab it. I'm just gonna piss me off if I don't get it. Okay, there's clearly nothing in here. I don't think there's anything back in here. What? What is this? What? This wasn't here. What is this? No, it's nothing. I just feel a little odd. You might not want to get too close to that. Do I touch it? I'm gonna touch it. Fuck, it hit me, didn't it? You died, bitch. What the fuck? Are we in Aloni? Wait, what? What? Just not iced. What an odd boy. Very odd. I'm a bit lost. Would you mind guiding me? It's fine. You should be able to see the way. I can't see too well. Me? I'm Fiona. I think that was it. You... Yes, you smell like tears. I'll call you Crybaby. No, I have no soul anymore. Just little teeny shards. It's his fault. All of it. Even the fact I won't be reborn.
Yes, yes, indeed. He's always been that way. Letting his hair grow long. I'm sure he learned how to cut it a long time ago. Honestly, it's so wimpy of him to be able to forget. He needs to break things off. He's not going to get anywhere dragging around all that weight. Not even knowing that, for all of his smarts, it pisses me off. He's an idiot. He is. Stupid. Stupid moron. Ugh. What? No, I'm not heavy. Sure, I did eat a lot, but I kept things under control. Ugh, let's go. Come on. What the fuck? Who are you, and why am I- where am I? I fear dreams, but I gotta fucking enter. There was a little house deep in the woods, apparently. In this little house lived a mother, a father, and a girl. Their lives were very needy, but in kindness to her mother and father, the girl endured her hunger. It happened very suddenly. Her mother, as if a changed person, began acting cold toward her daughter. As soon as her father went out, her mother dragged the girl out into the woods and told her this. There's no more food for you. You can't come back home. The woods were dark, and she didn't know her way back. The girl closed her eyes and thought, why? Is it because I was weak? That's why there's no food for me. As she mumbled to herself, a lone boy talked to the girl. I'll be strong so you can be weak. The girl was terribly surprised, and she said, yes, that's right, before falling asleep. The girl renounced having to face up to get herself. What? Is there another one? There was a little house deep in the woods. In this? Yeah, it's okay. Yeah, okay, so... is this the story of the one girl? Huh. Okay. Whoa. Oh, I guess I gotta follow the blood? These are all the storybooks. Okay. There was a white house near a flower garden. In this white house lived a mother, a father, and a girl. The father rarely came home to the house. The mother was old and frail, so the girl did various tasks in her stead. One day, on an errand, the girl broke a promise with her mother and picked flowers in the garden. The girl went to her grandmother's house with a kind person she met there. After the girl fetched some medicine, she returned to her grandmother, to her grandmother's room, to find that she had been eaten by a wolf. The girl was terribly scared and could not move from the spot. Then the wolf drew near her. The moment the wolf reached for the girl, the wolf was cut in twain. Behind the wolf stood her father, wielding an axe. The girls trembled at the sight of the slaughtered wolf and her red-stained father. Afterward, the girl ran all the way back home and locked herself in her room. There was the voice of her father. There was the voice of the girl, too. Father killed a person, but isn't it me who is most to blame? Was that father? Was it a person? The more she thought about it, the more the scene was jumbled in her head, so she decided not to think about it. The girl renounced having to acknowledge anything. Wow. Oh, so these are all tying together. Okay. Turquoise. Okay, so the stories are making more sense now. There was a large house in a large city. In this large house lived a mother, a father, a boy, the boy's brother and sister. And many other people. The boy had many things forced upon him, and he grew tired of it all. He found fun in sneaking out of his large house to adventure outside and telling his mother of his escapades. Many of the stories were lies, but his mother delighted at them and patted him on his head. One day, lightning struck, and father's castle was ruined. The castle crumbled, there was no money left, and the last time the boy saw his father, he was floating in midair. The boy informed his mother, but his mother said this. What are you saying at a time like this? We're all very exhausted right now. Don't tell such lies again. The boy tried to lead his mother the father again and again, but she let go of his hand every time. After some time, the boy's brother and sister led their mother toward where the father was. When I say it, you say it's a lie. Why? Is it because they have something and I have nothing? Did you know they were all lies before? Is it okay if you don't know their lies? The boy renounced having to improve himself. A black storybook. There was a little town deep in the woods. In this little town, there lived many people. They all lived healthy lives without sickness, but it struck suddenly one stormy night. A curse was laid on the forest. Many victims of the curse died every day, but a single girl did not fall victim to the curse. Many people felt pity for the girl, who had lost her family to the curse, and invited her to their homes. Yet the curse came once more, and the girl lost another family. After losing a fifth family, she met a person in the church who offered her an apple. This apple carries the curse of death. With this, you can go to heaven with the rest of them. But the girl refused, and that person too died of the curse. The girl deeply regretted not eating that apple. Soon, the girl began to harbor a hatred for living. The girl renounced having any attachment to life. This smell, there are books here. Then, maybe this is that library we used to go to. We loved it. All gone now, though. What a useless kid. Do you see a white notebook here? If you do, tell me. What is it? Haha, is that what you heard? The heart can't hurt you in a dream. And you know, maybe heaven and hell are pretty similar in the end. There's a simple reason why you come here. Probably because you lost XXX. Cat? You mean the one with the smarmy laugh? I wonder if he's the one I know. What? Did you believe everything that Cat said? The words of a demon who treats people's sorrows as his feast. How could you believe something you've never seen or experienced? Maybe you can believe because you had no clue. How strange. Liars are everywhere. The world can hardly contain them all. And gullible people are also everywhere. But it's only the gullible ones who get hurt. Maybe God's just a sadist. Just kidding. Ah, I love the smell of books. A lot of stuff's happening. But I'm assuming that the book we need, or want for that matter, is all the way in front of us. So let's go and find this book. Let's actually check these things out. What is it? A photo? A girl? How long's her hair? Color? Is she young? You sure are kind for answering all of those. That's my... our teacher. Beautiful, isn't she? She said she always wanted children and even found a fiancé. She also said she was already thinking up a name. I think it was... Chelsea. Chelsea? The character in the game? The someone we've already met? Oh, newspaper. Read it. Age 34 and age 32. Living in town. Or living in town. Where break-in and murder. The criminal has been, but the couple's son, outside the incident occurred, claimed that the shock upon returning home, memories. Furthermore, the criminal, a cat, suddenly appeared. What's wrong? You're shaking. No, don't say a word. I know it's something you don't want to know. There. That's my magic good luck charm. I found the white book, I guess. Before I go any further, the main character's family was murdered, and that shocked him into what he is amnesia. I guess it makes sense. Found it good. Will you show it to me?